Controlling the engine's operating temperature is key in maintaining maximum efficiency and in reducing emissions. And the thermostat plays an important role in doing just that. Today on the Trainer, we're going to take a closer look at the thermostat, its evolution, its role in the engine management system, and some testing tips so you can verify it's working the way it should. All that's next. Stick around. Research done in the 1920s found that a then major contributor to engine wear was the condensation of fuel on the cylinder walls of a cool engine. The condensing fuel effectively washed away any remaining lubricating oil that may have been left behind on the cylinder walls, and of course that led to accelerated piston, ring, and cylinder wall wear. The answer? The thermostat. The thermostat is a temperature-sensitive device that acts as a gateway, connecting the engine to the external cooling system. When the engine is cold, the thermostat is closed, separating the engine from the larger coolant circuit made up of the radiator and its connecting hoses. This allowed the engine to warm up faster and eliminated the fuel condensation issue. The first automotive thermostats were a bellows design, filled with an organic liquid that had a boiling point slightly lower than the desired engine operating temperature. As the engine approached this threshold, the fluid would begin to boil and the bellows would expand, opening a sheet brass plug and allowing the cooling fluid contained in the engine to circulate through the coolant circuit. Of course, the opposite is also true. As the engine's coolant began to cool, the fluid in the bellows would cease to boil, and the bellows would start to collapse, closing the brass valve. This allowed for control and some stabilization of the engine's operating temperature. Improvements to engine temperature control continued to develop. World War II aircraft were among the first to adapt pressurized cooling systems. Now, engines have an ideal operating temperature, and the advantage to pressurizing the cooling system was the ability to run closer to that ideal operating temperature without boiling over. However, the bellows-style thermostat didn't play well in pressurized systems. Not only did the pressurized system raise the boiling point of the engine's coolant fluid, it also raised the boiling point of the fluid in the bellows, and they would often shut unexpectedly, leading to overheating issues. To make pressurized systems work in the automobile, a new thermostat design was needed, and it's a design that is still in use today. Rather than rely on a liquid to gas transition to actuate the valve, a solid liquid transition is used in the form of a specialized wax pellet. As the temperature of the wax changes, it expands and contracts. When it expands, it operates a piston that opens the thermostat's valve. A tension spring presses against the valve and closes it when the operating temperature falls below the thermostat's opening threshold. Now, testing the operation of the thermostat can be done very simply with a few common tools. The first tool that I prefer is the use of a thermocouple, the one that came with this multimeter, and my scan tool. You can also use an infrared temperature gun or a thermal imaging camera to do the same measurements that I'm going to be doing with my meter. Begin the test by placing the thermocouple on the radiator hose connected to the radiator's inlet. Next, set up your scan tool in global OBD2 mode to read the engine coolant temperature sensor data PID, preferably in graph mode, so that you can see the progression of the engine's temperature as it begins to increase. Begin the test with a cold engine, that is one that's at ambient temperature, and just to be sure, make sure you leave the heater and air conditioning controls off so as not to do anything that might impact the test. Start the engine and allow it to idle. monitor the temperature change on the scan tool versus the actual temperature change that you're measuring at the thermostat outlet, that is, the radiator inlet hose going to the radiator. If you notice the temperature almost automatically starts to increase on startup, it's a good indication that the thermostat is not closing all the way. And that's a common cause of many thermostat performance-related diagnostic trouble codes. What you're looking for is the temperature on your meter to remain fairly constant as the engine first begins to warm up. As the engine temperature nears the thermostat's opening threshold, though, you'll see a slow rise in temperature on your meter as the thermostat begins to open. That rise should increase in rate as the ECT data pit reaches that threshold and should stabilize just past it. Now, typically, I'll expect to see a rapid change in the actual temperature measurement when the ECT data pit gets right around 195 to 200 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, keep in mind, I'm not going to necessarily see the actual measurement that I'm seeing on my data screen, depending on where I'm placing my thermocouple or taking my IR measurement. A lot of factors can affect that. What I'm looking for is the change, the trend, to let me know that the thermostat did indeed open. Now, during this test, if I'd noticed that the actual temperature reading was staying fairly constant or significantly lower, or didn't change once I got into that 195-200 range, I would suspect that the thermostat is not opening the way it should. Keeping the engine in its ideal operating temperature range is a must for maximum efficiency and reduced emissions. An engine that runs too cold will burn more fuel and make less power, while an engine that runs too hot could suffer accelerated wear or even internal component damage. Now, the ideal operating temperature is 230 degrees Fahrenheit, but that can vary with the various loads that the engine has to deal with in everyday driving, so maintaining that ideal temperature is quite the challenge. Part of the answer is the electrically assisted or MAP-controlled thermostat. This design is still a wax pellet design with one addition, an electric heating element embedded in the wax. Now the engineers can map out the ideal operating temperature for a variety of engine operating conditions, similar to the fuel map used to control fuel system strategies. The ECM is responsible for controlling the heating element based on data from other engine sensors related to speed and load. Heating the element independently allows the ECM to open the thermostat regardless of the actual coolant temperature. Any issues with the electrical heating element or its circuit will likely set a corresponding DTC in the ECM. But even if the heating element fails completely, the thermostat will still function as a conventional thermostat and can be tested in a similar way. While thermostats, both conventional and electrically controlled, are designed to last the life of the vehicle, there are some factors that can result in their premature demise. For example, a common mistake is the attempt to remove the heating element from the thermostat assembly. It can often be mistaken for an engine coolant temperature sensor, so be careful to check your service information before removing any retaining rings or attempting to remove the connector. Another common mistake is using sealant where no sealant is required. If the seal is a conventional O-ring style seal or the rubber around the thermostat type of seal, no sealant is required. Just make sure that the sealing surfaces are clean and free from any defect. Over and under torque while installing a new thermostat or thermostat module is another common mistake. Make sure that you look up and follow the torque procedures as outlined in your service information. Now, you've heard me talk about before how the cooling system and its components can be damaged by improper service of the cooling system, whether that's extended service intervals, not replacing the coolant when it's needed, or servicing the system with a coolant that doesn't match the OEM specifications. The thermostat's no exception to that. So if you do find yourself servicing the system for whether it's a normal maintenance service or you're replacing another cooling system component, it's a good idea to replace the thermostat or the thermostat module at the same time. The ability to precisely control the engine's operating temperature under a variety of conditions has come a long way since Henry Ford's Model T. But even so, the basic thermostat still plays a very important role in that management system. We hope you learned a little bit from today as the trainer. Thanks for watching. Mm-hmm.